This is why I made Jacki my girlfriend.
Oh my god. Oh! Ooh. Oh, it feels good.
Oh yeah, look, I see him too.
He kicked my butt.
We don't have the net out.
Oh, we don't have the net out. Jeez, do you see this? Do you hear this?
Net drag is tight.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Because we keep it tight, huh?
We keep it tight.
All right, get that net out.
Oh my god. First. Wow, look at
me. Right, you want me to just swing him in?
No, don't swing it in. Don't swing
it in. All right, let me get the net.
Get the net, get the net. We're not taking chances. He's so dark.
Yeah, he is a pretty one.
You're so strong. I can't believe I did that. I can't believe I did that.
You want an Adam?
Yeah.
There you go.
Thank you. Oh my gosh. Woo! He got
me. Good job,
so
babe.
So dark.
That is a pretty one.
Oh, look, my net is making its color go. Wow. This is also a very special fish because I haven't caught a fish in like 2 months. Oh, don't want him to flip over.
Pull him.
Oh. Look how pretty. I want to hold them, but they're so spiny and sharp. It's just, you don't want to hold them when they're too alive, but it's so exciting. As soon as you feel them bite, you just rip up on them and you're in for a major fight because they're so strong. A bent pipe that comes out under the water that if you don't know the rigs, you wouldn't know it's there. So it's so fun when you get one, but it's kind of sad when you lose them. You knew. Oh my god, he's gonna pull me out of the boat. He's gonna jump.
Oh. Keep it on this side. The video is going.
Oh my god.
You want to net him too?
I can't even pull up and. Oh my god, he's gonna. What the fuck?
Hey, you want to net?
Oh my gosh, he's going crazy.
Watch me.
Oh! Woo! Tripletail number 3. Oh, I got it out.
Yeah, good job.
That's how you do that, and then watch this. That's how you.
Oh, wait.
Half. ended off with 3 triple tail, but we gave one to our buddy Bubba at Venice Marina. So come with me, let's go get the fish out of the boat. I forgot to put my beer down.
Yep.
Oh, I hate when there's a bunch of ice water.
Just throw them on the concrete.
Throw them down?
Yeah, that way you don't get my boat all nasty. Then you can pick them up again when you get down.
I don't want to beat the meat.
You ain't gonna beat the meat.
You don't want to beat your meat.
No, but I don't want
it.
Sure?
To...
Yeah. Oh, the meat's no good on that side.
We're tenderizing it.
Yeah.
Hold my beer.
Hold my beer. Watch this. Do some fish squats.
Oh, I should do a fish squat. I haven't done one in a while.
Come on, girl.
Ready?
Yeah.
Oh, it feels good.
All right, come on.
Okay. I'm gonna clean the small one. You can clean the big one.
All right, where's the knife?
I gotta go get it.
All right.
Let's go get it. All right. Lewis just cleaned his, because he kind of re-taught me how to clean a triple tail. Like, I've cleaned triple tail before, but I don't think I was really doing it the right way, like the best way. So he just went over with me. Now I'm gonna do it. He did it perfectly. Look at that. And we got the cheek meat out. That's a little triple tail cheek. It's really good. Really tasty. So we'll show you how to get those out too. And I'm using the Dexter serrated edge fillet knife, because the triple tail scales are so thick. You gotta have like a strong serrated edge knife to really rip through those big thick scales. And I have a discount code for Dexter too if you wanna buy some Dexter fillet knives. I prefer them. I think they're my favorite so far. So we're using the Dexter. Look at the chickens eating the triple tail. Oh, they don't want it. They don't want to be in the video. They love it.
They think you're trying to get them.
Yeah, they don't. We gotta leave them alone.
Right. What a beautiful. Hold on. I just want to start by saying this. What a beautiful day.
It is a beautiful day. Why are you making fun of me?
Yes.
Okay. So look at the triple tail really quick. Its scales are like really thick and they're big, and it's got all these sharp, this gill plate right here is like sharper than this knife. It's serrated. Like, it's got really thick. This will freaking cut your fingers off. And then they've got big pokers right here, spiky pokes here. These are all, look how thick and pointy and sharp these are. All these back dorsal fin spines right here, down here even, you can see how thick and just sharp and pointy they are. This thing is just like designed to not be touched. So that's why I don't like to handle them too much when they're alive, because they'll flip around and you get poked by one of those, you're screwed. And they have teeth too, so, you know, just great. I'm a little nervous because this is like a new way. But there's this little hard part right here. And you cut straight.
Yeah, always try to angle your knife underneath them scales like that. Yep.
I haven't filleted a fish in a long time.
I know.
Alright, so you get that, because that's hard right there, so you don't cut that. You gotta get right behind it. And then get a little start right here along the backbone. And then I want to grab it so that I can get a good grip on it. And then line out the back. along the bones. Okay, now this is where I get screwed.
Eyeballs, yeah, they're under the gill.
There we go. I still don't feel like I have a good.
No, you're doing good. Well, your hand's hitting the P-row. You need to slide the fish closer to the edge.
All right, all right. There we go, there we go, you're right. Okay, now you need a cut here.
Yeah, so, but it ain't. It's just like this.
Right down there, because all this is just guts and ribs, and you don't really need that. So you just start and keep it easy on yourself and start up here and then go down.
Right, well first finish lining it out. And you peel, you stick your hand under there. That way you can peel it up.
You want me to start doing that now?
Yeah, yeah. Do your thing like you normally do. This is why I made Jacki my girlfriend. Because
he watched me clean a hogfish in the Bahamas, which I gotta say is like one of the easier fish to fillet. Because they're just nice and soft, and there's not a bunch of.
She usually scrapes all the meat off the bones.
Get it good.
Yeah. So,
if you're really good at filleting, you don't have to look up in there. You can kind of just feel it. Right? I like to look, though. I'm like, just got to make sure I get it all. Okay.
Now. That's good. Okay. Now, turn them. Yep. Turn them like that.
Yes.
And when you peel this up and cut, it'll let you file at a bone just right.
Okay.
It's not way over here.
It's up.
Like yeah, it's way up there.
All right.
Yep, and you just.
Oh, I can feel it.
Yeah.
Maybe I went too far.
There you go. Now you're right.
Wait.
No, you're doing perfect. No, oh, start curving down now. It's constantly getting round. There you go.
I'm not like behind those scales.
There you go. All right, straight to those fins. There you go. Oh, don't cut my boat.
I didn't want to do it on the P row. I'm not strong. There we go.
There you go. Now curve it back towards his tail.
Oh.
You got to trim that tail out. Yep.
And then very important too is knock your scales off. And then line out, the rest of the fish. Shallow cut. And then you can follow the bones for the rest of it. Okay. I'm getting it.
Now spin them another way and do them some.
Oh, you mean?
Yeah. There you go.
Oh yeah, much better. I got it. There.
There you go. You got it. Now.
So you can see. Where do I hold them at? I guess just hold them.
Now just rip it out, because there's no meat by the tail. Rip it. There you go. Do it one more time.
All right.
Not bad.
Not bad.
Not bad. Got all the meat off the bone.
On the first side. Okay, let's do the other side. Really quick. All right.
There you go.
Okay, like that now.
Yeah. There you go.
Okay. Gotta kind of awkwardly.
No, look, you just, look, when you're cutting right here, hold them right there.
I can't get a good grip like that.
Well, look, hold your hand. This is what I do. I hold my hand flat. And I put my fingers under his gills like this. Ooh. That way I ain't cutting towards my hand.
That's what I need to know.
Okay. There you go.
It's about getting a good grip on them. That's sometimes my problem, is I can't get a good grip on them.
Yeah. noticed. I was laughing at the scales flying in your face and in your shirt. Look, yeah.
All right, well, there's my other piece.
Not so bad.
Not bad. It's a really hard fish to clean though. And I'm not very strong right now either. I haven't worked out or used my muscles in over 2 months, so. You gotta have some muscle to clean fish. Now we can do the cheek, right?
Yep.
So, this way?
Yeah, yeah. Watch your finger. There you go. Now curve it up towards his eye.
So you get right on this bone right here, you can hear that. And then drop, just follow it down. And then, like this, and then you can peel the meat out.
Well, you gotta cut it towards the eyeball. There you go. Curve the knife up. Don't let it keep grinding in the bone. There you go, right there.
All
right,
so you gotta cut it. Now you can just rip it out nice and smooth. Release it right there. Ooh. And there you go. A little triple tail cheek. It usually peels out, but look how clean it comes off the skin right there. Just like that. I probably could have done a little better, but I've never done that before. Okay, so we got our triple tail fillets. Our cheeks, scales everywhere, and we had a good day of fishing. I hope you guys like this video. Let me know how you want me to cook this for the next one. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and I'll see you guys in my next video.